The problem what, because I did that. The way I got into national soccer, I like saw three people. Hey, oh God, you're selling for so much.
Okay.
We're going to come in, we're going to start. So what that does is, it attracts people who have a natural affinity towards natural products. They come to know you, they come to know that you make products, and through that your products start selling. The price of your product will just double and triple just because of the container. Like what I'm doing right now is what I did before. I'm just doing it at scale. I'm doing more videos, doing more soaps, doing more of what I did earlier. It's not even about enjoying, it's like if you're doing things like the way you are.
My actual dream is to set up a brand.
Okay.
Brand that reaches everyone.
Okay.
And which should be it should be natural.
Okay.
Healthy, natural.
Okay. Okay.
And so, environment friendly.
Why do you believe? Do you believe that, or yeah. Do you say that just because
I believe
everyone
I
are doing that?
No, I totally believe it.
Yeah.
I love nature.
Okay. Okay.
Like that.
Because I know a person where I buy my oils and all from. Yeah. His lifestyle is that. He buys only things that are natural. If anything is not natural, he doesn't touch it. Things like that.
Yeah.
So when he does something natural and when he talks about it, it resonates with the people who's talking with.
Okay, yeah.
But yeah. If you truly believe that and if your way of life is that, you can go into it. But believe me, if it is not that, and if you're starting something just because everyone is doing that, and I'm not saying you're doing that.
Yeah, I got it.
The problem what, because I did that. The way I got into national soccer, I like saw three people. Hey, oh God, you're selling for so much.
Okay.
We're going to come in, we're going to start. But what happens is, at a point of time, the reason my brand is not working so well is, one reason is that. There's not a lot of innovations in it. We still have the same products which we started off from. But apart from that, you see outside there'll be a lot of innovations here. So what happened was, I was not comfortable delivering the message. And I truly didn't believe in it. So I couldn't convey the message outside. So which negatively impacted my brand.
So okay, if I say something helping nature, my brand will be helping nature, biodegradable.
Okay.
Something like that.
Okay.
And 100% truly natural.
Okay.
Will that work out?
It will work out, provided if you your lifestyle is that way.
Okay.
And you share things that will help people to live a more natural way of life.
Okay.
Apart from the soap salon.
Oh, apart from the soap salon, I should inculcate another natural resources in my...
Correct. In your lifestyle.
Daily life.
Correct. Say, it can be even as simple as... You go to a shop, you eat something, you see a paper which is like not biodegradable or something, you find them and show them a biodegradable alternative, or you go take it and properly dispose it in the proper place, put that on video. So what that does is, it attracts people who have a natural affinity towards natural products. They come to know you, they come to know that you make products, and through that your products start selling. If you're not comfortable doing that, there's no point in making a natural brand.
Yeah.
Because for me personally, it doesn't make a difference.
Mm.
A plastic plate or a paper plate, it doesn't make a difference.
Okay.
And in packaging, when you're going completely natural, there's a lot of limitations. And to satisfy those limitations, your prices go up.
Okay.
Yep. See, for containers, if you remove plastic containers, what are the options you've got? One is either aluminium or glass. Both of them are very expensive. So the price of your product will just double and triple just because of the container.
Okay. Then prices will be going up. Yeah.
Yeah, it would go up. But it doesn't matter to the people who truly believe natural is the way of life. So what work do we do? We just put a camera over there and I do have two people to edit and everything is automated from there.
Yeah.
Initially it was me sitting in front of camera and doing things.
Okay.
What I'm doing right now is what I did before. I'm just doing it at scale. I'm doing more videos, doing more soaps, doing more of what I did earlier. That's
okay.
All.
Okay, you are branding your image. means
correct
and you are expanding your reach.
Correct. So I do like designing packages, you know, making new things. See, today there's this new red color cardboard box.
Yeah.
A new order came, they wanted something different. So I enjoy doing things like this.
Okay.
Something which nobody else can do or nobody would do. In 2 days time, we got made these, all the boxes, did the packaging and we're shipping the product.
Okay.
So I enjoy things like that. So I enjoy doing it and I do make it a video and that will in turn come out as a product.
Yeah. Okay.
End of the day, you shouldn't feel like you're working. I think that is one big reason people like step into entrepreneurship and things like that. When you're at work, you're being told something. There's a set of rules which you need to operate by. So when coming out, there is a freedom, but
there will be much more work.
Yeah, but if you do things that
if you enjoy your work and you'll find you won't feel very bad.
Yeah. It's not even about enjoying. It's like if you're doing things like the way you are, you're just existing. Same. And it generates a revenue for you.
Yeah. Okay, fine. I'll buy some kit.
Yeah. That's all? You've traveled all the way from Bangalore. If you want to know something more,
I'm like
very willing to help you.
Yeah.
Is there anything else?
Nothing. Just I'll start making some soaps by me.
Yeah. Go talk to people. Understand what their problem is. List your friends or something like that. It can be anything. Just come up with an idea and I'll give you products for it.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thanks.
Okay. All the best.